Hey there, HPI Guys Model Workshop. We're progressing on the Daryl Dixon Walking Dead diorama build. What I've done so far, and I'll show you a short slideshow in a second, is I've attached the cork to the clear base. I've made the grass transition. And then I've taken Elmer's school glue and sort of dumped it out on the surface and taken my cheap paintbrush and smeared it all over. Now my next step to make this look like a more realistic roadbed, of course the cork looks as a great base, and this glue is going to dry clear, is to start adding some sand. And I just went out to my cactus garden and scooped up some real sand, and I'm going to start to sprinkle it all over, and you're going to see, I'm just going to go like that, and a little bit more. It's kind of a messy one, so you want to have a garbage bag available when you're all done. And what I'll do is, when I've got both hands free, when I'm done filming, is I'm going to start to spread this out into the glue. And the nice thing is, like I said, the glue is going to dry clear because Elmer's school glue dries kind of a clumpy clear. And I'm just going to keep spreading this out until I think it's satisfactory as a gravel road. Now, I don't want to cover the whole thing with sand. I just want to cover it enough, and I want to cover this transition area between the gravel road and the dirt road, because of course it's never smooth, you know, when you get to the two. So I'm just going to keep spreading this out, and of course some of the stones are bigger, but it doesn't matter. It's the apocalypse. I doubt the county road crews are out maintaining everything. Then the next step, what I'm going to start doing once I'm done with this, I'm going to hit it with a heat gun, because Elmer's school glue is water-based. It's going to dry much faster with a heat gun, and I can keep progressing. And then I'm going to start to build the fence. Once I build the fence, then I'm going to take all the fence pieces. I'm going to try to weather them up a little bit with some gray paint, make them look a little older, bust them up, break them up a little bit. Just see if I can do a little bit of weathering on them. Then I will start laying in the shrubs and the other branches and trees and stuff like that along the roadbed. Some weeds in the way, some tumbleweeds, some brush that's fallen in the road. And then I will move on to start placing my figures. And we're moving right along. So thanks for watching. We're going to do a short little slideshow to show you how I got to this point, which didn't take long at all. That's why I didn't want to cover every little step. And then we'll be back. All right, I'm back, and what I'm doing now is working on the two-rail fence. And it's just a very simple fence structure. What I did to make things measure up correctly, remember like I said, I want to have this guy with his guts hanging out. I want to have him hanging over the edge of the fence here. So what I did was I broke a bunch of those bamboo skewers to the size. I just made a random size. I stacked them on the floor, and you know, they're all different sizes because they're rough cut cedar posts is what they would have out there in the sticks. And then I took them, and after I measured up against where the bar would be underneath his guts here, then I just lined them all up next to each other so that they had the exact same starting point in the ground. And then all I did was I just started marking them with a black fine tip marker. And you can see that looks nice and square enough for a hand-built fence. I'm going to start gluing it together. Once I get it all glued together, then once we get a focus here, then I will start weathering it, and we'll come back. Hey there, back again. We've got the fence installed. Now, I did have some issues when I drilled through with that grass mat lifting up a little bit as each hole I drilled through. But again, don't worry, because we're going to be putting some shrubs and everything around the bases of each post, like weeds would grow up. So you're really not going to notice any of that. And all I got to do is throw a little bit more glue and sand in there, and it's all going to fade away. You can see that the roadbed is drying nicely, and the glue is mostly disappearing as it dries. It's not completely dry yet. You can see the grass back there, which we're going to be covering with some shrubs and brush and dirt and grass and taller weeds. And we've got the fence here. Now, I've busted through part of the fence, and the posts are kind of wonky because, remember, it's an old farm fence along a road. I've never seen one in perfect condition unless it was brand new. This is most certainly the apocalypse. Keep remembering that. Things are going to be beat up. So I'm going to trim off that excess wood where it's busted through there. And you can also see on the post where I've added some nails, how they turn black like that. I just used a standard old Sharpie, ultra fine. Made those little dots on there. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to start washing the fence with some, what do we call this, barn wood. and some raw umber after that. I'm just going to mix up a really sloppy wash and let the wood soak that up. And then we're going to glue the fence posts in place. We're going to place our shrubs and brushes, and we're going to keep moving right along. So there we are with the roadbed, the grass, and the fence. We'll be back. All right, I've got the fence mounted, and I've got the excess cut off and some scraps down there on the ground. I've patched where the grass pulled up with some more sand and white glue, and that's drying nicely. You can see as it dries, it tends to disappear. You can see it a little thicker around the base of the post because I kind of wanted to glue them in place after I drilled them through into the ground. Now you can see this fence is weathered. This fence is brand new. How I did that was I made a wash of the barn wood, which is just Windex and paint till it's real thin. Okay, see it just drip, 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 real thin. Then I slathered that all over the fence, the whole thing. I painted it all up with it. Then I took some raw umber and I squirted into a little paint palette here, and I used the exact same brush, and I dipped it in, and wipe, 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 dipped it in, wipe, 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 wipe. And then I just kind of made swipes anywhere. Remember, this is an old beat-up fence. It's been painted, repainted, faded, paint's peeling. It's been weathered. It's been smashed through by something. Who knows what? The fence is beat to hell, so there's no right, there's no wrong way in doing this. So, again, and as you can see on the weathered one, my nail holes, my weathered, my black oxide nail holes are gone. So I'm just going to reapply those when we're all done. I'm just going to dab them on there again. But this side is pretty much done. So is the stuff on the ground. And then this side, all we have to do is paint it and weather it. And that's quite easy. What I'll do is I'll go back over here and I'll soak that brush up and I'll just glom it on there. Okay? Just put it on there. Bob Ross, just put your paint where you want your paint to be, because this is Bob Ross's apocalypse painting, and we're just going to put some barnwood gray on here. This fence has been here for a real long time, and there's no happy little trees over it. Nope, just zombies all over the damn place, and we've got to triple tap them, because if you don't triple tap them, they're going to come back. So anyways, while I lose my mind there and do a bad imitation of Bob Ross, I'm painting this fence with one hand and filming with the other. And you can see as I apply the barnwood, then it starts to look gray and weathered. And, you know, it already gets that tint to it. Then I let that dry. And we don't have to let it dry right now. But then what I do is I go back here and I get most of that wet paint off. Then I dab, 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 dab. And I get some off here. And then I go back over here with the same brush and I touch a little bit here, a little bit there, kind of, okay, you know, we're getting a little bit on there. See how it's starting to look like this one? And the paint darkens as it dries. So we're just going to go bang, bang, zoom, get a little on there, a little over here. This one kind of screwed up too. And you know, we're just going to beat the heck out of these things. And I'm going to keep doing that. And then I hit it with the heat gun. And then I go back and I keep weathering it till finally I achieve the result I want, which is that. And I'm going to match this side up to it. And then I'm going to come back, and when I come back, I'm going to start pinning the zombies and Daryl and putting some lichen in place. So I'm going to get quite a few steps done. Check it out. We're getting really close to the end here. I've got some lichen. I've got some small plants. I've got some HO scale or O scale corn stalks in there. I've got the guy with his guts out. Look at that, hanging over the fence. That is so sweet. Check it out. It's starting to look pretty apocalyptic right now. I love saying that word. Now, how am I getting the figures to stay on this board? Well, for the plants and stuff, I drill very small holes with my Moto tool. And a little advertisement for Moto tool. I've had this tool for at least 20 years now, if not longer. I think I got it when I was about 12, so probably 27 years. And it's still going strong. It chucks a little rusty from all those years of use, but it's still working great. Anyways, I drill little holes all over wherever I want stuff, and I just sink them in, and then I use some CA glue, and I apply it with simple old toothpicks from the dollar store, 500 for a buck, and I've been, you know, beating it up And I weathered the fence like you saw, and I got the broken fence and the broken weeds. Those corn stalks look great, like dead weeds. They just look amazing. And I showed you how I got all that stuff earlier, and then I took the hanging out gut zombie because, you know, someone drove by and slash, and his guts fell out. Now he's stuck on the fence. What a bummer. He's just hanging out there. And if you've seen The Walking Dead, you know a lot of zombies just end up hanging out in places. Now, I'm going to be placing Daryl on the bike and this burned up zombie in the actual diorama in the road. So what I need to do is I go underneath and I cut their feet flat. They usually come with these pegs for other displays. And I cut their feet flat. And then I take my moto tool again. And I drill right up inside a leg. Or in Daryl's case, when I have him out here, I'll have a tire. And I'll drill up inside. And then I use threaded rod. And my threaded rod comes from Carl Goldberg Models. This is what I use for my model airplane. So I just use this stuff when I'm also doing figure models and whatnot. And I'll find a good place for him and I'll drill a hole and I'll put him in and then I'll find out how much of this rod I need and I will cut it off and then I will use the CA glue and I will stick him in place. And for him, I'll use some zip kicker right here. That'll just make the glue dry instantly. It dries in a couple seconds and then he'll be in here permanently. And then we'll have Daryl. Daryl's going to be in the road here. So as soon as I pin these guys and put them in, we are done. Now, as far as decorating, what have I used so far? I've used the Woodland Scenics lichen right there, just natural lichen. It's like a rubberized blown. I've used some of the what they call pollen. It's just a grass dust. You can see I've sprinkled it over. And that helps cover up some of the glue too, the Elmer's glue. And it sticks right to it. And I've used some of those little trees back there that you can see I got on clearance for only $3.59. Those look like cute little shrubs in this scale, don't they? You come back here, they look like shrubs. And then I've used some what are actually cotton plants. Cotton plants from JTT, and again, on clearance. I just used a few. I think I used about five of them. And in this scale, they just look like flowering weeds. You know, I've got them all hidden all over places and stuff. And then I use the corn stalks, and there's a, I don't know how many are in a package, like 28, and I've only used like 6 or 7, so you can make a ton of dioramas, but that's where we are so far. And I sprinkled some of the grass into the dirt road. When we come back, this diorama is going to be complete, and I'll be putting the cover on it, so stay tuned. All right, model fiends, here we have it. This is the completed Daryl Dixon Walking Dead diorama of my interpretation of when Daryl was at Herschel's farm. I take some creative license in it. Everything that's happening in this diorama didn't happen on the TV show. It's just what I decided to do with the figures that I found for inexpensive prices and, you know, a craft frame, a box, and some cork boards, some dirt, and you know, other hobby materials using really easy-to-do hobby techniques. Now, you can see on here, I think it looks really nice. I don't have a turntable here. But of course, being a diorama, it's full 3D. You know, it's going to look good from any angle. The only thing that makes me nervous is getting this over to that person's house. Because even though guy, you know, they're pinned in there. I mean, they're really in there strong. You know, he wiggles a little bit. But, they, you know, that's the only thing that I'm kind of worried about. What I'm going to do is the cover fits on really tight. So I am going to end up taking this over there without the cover on it and on the passenger seat of my truck, and then I'll fit the cover on just in case anything comes loose. Now, since the last time we talked, the only thing that I did different when I said I was going to pin Daryl in, and he is. I used two pins, one in each tire, sunk them all the way through, used the threaded end on Daryl because he's really heavy, so I wanted him to hold in place, and I used extra CA glue and extra accelerator, and then I pulled it over to the edge of the work desk, you know, over here on the edge, and then what I did was I went underneath with CA glue and smeared it around his pins and shot them with activator, and they dried instantly, so it's almost like a bolt on the bottom of that rod down there. Now, you can see everything that we were working on before, just as one big diorama. What I did before I was all done was on Mr. Blood and Guts here, Mr. Fence Hanger, I took some Future Floor Wax, Pledge Future Floor Wax, or as I call it, the Poor Man's Clear Coat, and I smeared it all in there, and I don't know if it's cameras picking it up, but I wanted the guts to look wet and gooey, you know, because they would be. So I have them on there so that it looks kind of slimy and nasty. And that's the effect I wanted for that. But everything else is nice and dry. The Elmer's glue is set. Elmer's school glue works great on projects like this. We've got the look I wanted. We've got the shrubs, the busted fence, the weeds, the two zombies as Daryl approaches. He's got his badass crossbow right there. He's got his knife on him. You know, he's popping down a gear so he can get off the bike and start killing some dudes. So, again, thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope, even if you're not a Walking Dead fan, that you enjoyed watching me build this, that you think it's kind of cool. Now, for the last part of the diorama, let's just raise the camera a little bit so you can see. We'll take the cover once it's at their house, and you can see, remember the photograph I showed you in part one? And we'll just place it over like that. And check it out, it's got the cool little photograph in the back with the farm off in the distance. And I don't know how well that's gonna show up on camera. We'll see if we can lower it down. But you can see it, and in person you can see it crystal clear. But on camera it's probably not going to show up so well with that glass case because it's so shiny. So that's it, folks. That is the Daryl Dixon Walking Dead diorama. It's going to look great. I think they're going to like it. I hope they like it a lot. It's going to be delivered in a couple days, and then I will be starting my next project. Once again, thanks for watching HPI Guys Model Workshop.